The ghost took Scrooge to Bob's house. Bob's wife had made Christmas dinner for the family, and they were eating it together. Although their house was small and they didn't have much food, they were happy. Scrooge saw Bob's son, Tiny Tim, who was a sickly child. He asked the ghost if Tim would survive.
"Not unless things change," replied the ghost.
Scrooge heard the clock strike again, but when he looked around, he was alone. Then a dark, cloaked figure, the ghost of Christmas Future, approached him. Without speaking, the ghost showed Scrooge a funeral. Only a few people were there. Nobody seemed to care that the dead man was gone.
"Who died?" asked Scrooge.
The ghost pointed to a tombstone that read, "Ebenezer Scrooge." Scrooge began to cry and shouted, "I can change!"
第一天的故事提到会有三个幽灵来找 Scrooge。第一位是过去的圣诞幽灵，他带 Scrooge 去看他年轻时快乐的圣诞节。那第二位是现在的圣诞幽灵，他带 Scrooge 到员工 Bob 他们家。那他们全家人正在享用圣诞晚餐，虽然房子不大，也没有很多食物，可是他们很快乐。Scrooge 看到 Bob 的儿子是一个体弱多病的孩子，他问幽灵那个孩子能不能活下来。幽灵回答说，除非情况改变，否则不会。那这时候 Scrooge 再次听到钟响，他看看四周，突然就只剩他一个人了。我们先看一下单字 reply， 这个动词它表示回答、回应。 alone 则是形容独自一人的、孤独的。 sickly 则是形容体弱多病的。好，那故事接着写到，有一个披着斗篷的黑暗身影走向了 Scrooge， 那是未来的圣诞幽灵。幽灵一句话都没说，他就只让 Scrooge 看一场葬礼，那边只有少数几个人在场，似乎没有人在乎死者。那当 Scrooge 问说是谁死了，幽灵就指着一块墓碑，上面写着他的名字 Ebenezer Scrooge。 于是 Scrooge 就开始哭泣啊，哭着说他可以改变。好，我们补充一下， cloak 当动词可以表达使披上斗篷。那文中用到 cloaked 是过去分词当形容词来描述披着斗篷的。那么 tombstone 就是指墓碑、墓石。那这边一个重点，我们进入文法时间。这边我们来看连接词 unless， 它表示除非、如果不怎么样。那么引导副词子句，主词加动词，这时候它可以摆在句首或句中。举例来说，出去玩的时候我比较倾向搭当地的大众运输而不是租车，这时候也许我可以说I'd prefer not to rent a car unless it's really necessary， 除非真的有必要，否则我宁愿不租车。
Suddenly, Scrooge was back in his bed, and it was Christmas morning. He immediately got up and bought a huge turkey, which he sent to Bob's house. He walked the streets in a happy mood, wished Merry Christmas to everyone that he passed, and gave money to charity. The old Scrooge was gone.
刚刚我们读到 Scrooge 哭喊着说他可以改变，那突然间他就回到了床上，时间已经是圣诞节的早上，他立刻起身买了一只巨大的火鸡，把火鸡送到员工 Bob 家。那他心情愉悦地走在街上，祝福着路过的每个人圣诞快乐，然后也捐款给慈善机构。看来啊，过去那个充满怨恨只爱钱的 Scrooge 已经不存在了。我们来看单字 hugeHuge 是形容巨大的、庞大的。那么 mood 它表示心情、情绪或者是心境。那这边一个重点，我们进入文法时间。这边要介绍的是 wish 的不同意思及用法。我们来看第一个用法是表达祝福、祝愿，用法是 wish something to somebody 或者是 wish somebody something， 像是 we wish happiness to you and your family，我们祝福你和你的家人幸福快乐，或是一首常见的歌 We wish you a Merry Christmas， We wish you a Merry Christmas， 是我们祝你圣诞快乐。那第二个用法是但愿、希望的意思，用来表达不太可能实现的愿望，后面的子句可以接 were 这个动词或者是过去式动词，表达说与现在事实相反的愿望，所以它的句型就是 wish that主词加上 were 或者是过去式动词。例如 I wish I were there to celebrate with you， 我真希望当时能在那里和你一起庆祝。 I wish I had an invisible cloak. 我真希望有一件隐形斗篷。那么第三个用法是 wish 后面可以接不定词 to be 或者是接 for 加名词，表达希望做某事或是想要什么。这时候 wish 的语气会比 want 来得正式。例如 The little girl wished for a puppy for Christmas. 那个小女孩圣诞节想要一只狗。